Hello everybody, this is Toys R Us, and for this video we're going to do something slightly different. I've had lots of messages since I've started this channel on, you know, how to look out for things, and I've started adding them as a regular feature into my videos of things you need to be aware of if you're after purchasing things yourself, and especially if you want to display them. So what I'm going to do with this, I'm going to share with you a video on Sunfade. I'm going to show you some of the Sunfaded figures that I've actually got. And again, just to make you aware of it, because it is, unfortunately, and again, especially with them being such older toys, it's something that, you know, it does happen. It happens quite a lot, and it can really detract away from the figure. Some pictures you can't even really tell. So it's, as I say, it's ideal to get full pictures of everything that you want to see, especially if it's not like a white figure. If it's a white figure, it's quite hard to notice the actual sun fade. But one of the main reasons, and you probably wouldn't believe it, but literally, and it's a good job I did it off camera because I did unfortunately swear, if you get sun fade, it can make the plastic slightly more brittle. And if you look at the double dealer weapons in front of you, and I'm laughing now because I've got to, because I can't believe it literally just happened about 36 before I did this. I was just setting all these up here. I was only going to use the top half of the double dealer weapon, but it was attached to the one that's been sitting in its rocket mode for, well, I don't know, years. Even though it's sun faded, it does need an upgrade, but there you go. So this is the original, you can see, lovely, bright and shiny grey. And then this is a sun faded one. They're exactly the same. One's just had too much time in the sun. And I literally, unfortunately, disconnected it from the other part and it snapped right there. So sun fade, not only is it not a nice thing to see, it does detract away from the actual, as I say, overall presentation and how the figure displays, but it also makes the plastic far, far more brittle. And this literally, I keep saying literally, it's just snapped just before I did the video. So that's one thing that perhaps I didn't want to show you is in much detail, but there you go, you've got to see it. So that's what it can do with the greys. As I said, that's what color it should be. I've got another example of a grey, and funnily enough, I found this out as well. You can't really tell there, see, with that angle. So if this was photographed right now and you were looking to buy it, it doesn't necessarily look that bad. However, if I go and put the lovely one that it should be right next to it, now there's a difference. There's a huge difference. So as I say, this one is sun faded. It's something to be aware of. You might want to ask for camera for pictures, as I say, without the flash, etc. But you can clearly see now the difference between the two. And to be honest, it's a thing that I've been caught out with absolutely loads of times when buying secondhand figures. That's something to be aware of. You can't always detect it for that reason. It's only really detectable, let's be honest, on these guys, on the white figures. And I'm looking at this through the camera right now and obviously in person. And funnily enough, even through the camera, it doesn't look half as bad as what it is. You can clearly tell there's a bit of a yellow there compared to the white. Ignore the difference of the variance with the cross on the roof. But now when I hold it closer, it's apparent, but again, in person, right in front of me now, this looks really yellow. It looks really bad. So even with the camera and the lighting on it, it's not as noticeable. So you really need to be aware of sun fade. You've seen that it damages and actually cracks, unfortunately, plastic. But this is what sometimes you can't tell either on the boxes. So the front of there looks pretty nice. If I bring it closer, you can barely make out there's some sun fade on there. But as soon as I turn the box up, you got some sun fade on the artwork there. So again, I mean, luckily enough, the seller for this had full, you know, about 15, all 12 pictures, so I could tell it was sun faded, because otherwise you wouldn't have been able to tell that at all. So be aware for the sun fade on the boxes. This guy, again, he just looks a tiny bit sun faded at the front. Not too bad, just looks a bit faded. But then when you spin it round, again, luckily enough, the seller showed me all these pictures and that's barely even visible. It's really, really bad. So if you are looking, and if you got looking to take the next step into buying boxed figures and stuff, you need to be aware of this. This is a, obviously, classic release Octane. And again, from that angle, it doesn't look too bad, but the bubble inside is really yellowed. So not only does it get the figures and the boxes, that's obviously supposed to be your clear bubble. You can't really tell there, actually. I need something white. If I get something white like this, there you go, that's how yellowed that is. So that's something else to be aware of. Again, this is one of the first videos that I'm going to be doing along these lines, using some information to teach you as much as I can. Any other questions you've got regarding things like this, I'd love to show you. So please keep your questions coming. I'll do some more educational videos, and take care and subscribe for more.